from the ashes of my career burnout, a single question arose within me. How does one raise like a phoenix to join the top 1% of software engineers? Driven by that spark, I kept searching until I found a Reddit post that was really interesting and finally answered my question. I read through every suggestion and comment on that thread, and here is what I learned. So the first comment that took my eye was this one. Forget work-life balance, only perfection matters. To be honest, at first I thought, why should I burn out myself to make someone else richer? But more I thought about it, it rang more true. And the thing is, to crack to the top 1%, you need to sacrifice. You cannot go to your job at 9 and leave at 5. And when you are at home or through weekend, don't touch your laptop and expect to go among the 1%, because there is definitely someone who is grinding through dinner, coding past midnight, and spending weekends learning a new tool. And that guy is the one that is going to leave you behind. I know it sounds harsh, but believe me, guys, it's the plain truth. To join the top 1%, you need to sub out your comfort zone. You need to work hard and let the hard work carry you forward. Another comment that also cuts straight to the chase is this one. If you lack ambition, you are just a puppet. At first, it feels like the guy is insulting, but the more you think about it, more you see the truth. Hard work without a goal is just busy work. You need a fire inside you. You need a clear, burning aim you can't ignore. Without that drive, even the best routines lose their spark and everything falls apart. So let's go to the other brilliant comment. 95% hard work, 5% talent. There is a cold reality. No amount of coffee will turn a potato into a Ferrari. If your brain is stuck in reverse, you will never outrun someone born with that spark. If you are not smart, then it's like showing up to a drag race with a tricycle. Then you will eat dust every time. To be in top 1%, you need that genetic. You need to be smart. Maybe you are talking about top 10, top 20, top 20%, then hard work would be enough. But believe me, guys, if you want to be among top 1%, then you need to be talented. But let's pause for a moment. If you are still watching this video and still you haven't hit the like button, please do that. Because that is the thing that keeps the fire inside me turned on. So if you do that, I would be really, really happy. And you are doing something really, really good for me. We want to create a good community here. We want to grow together. So let's keep it running, guys. The other comment that also cut through my eyes is this guy who is talking about luck. I really believe in luck. I have a friend who is a DevOps wizard, but he's always stuck in interviews because he cannot explain himself. And I know another guy named Chad, and this Chad crushed the production a couple of times, but he has a six-figure salary because his cousin is the CTO of the company. I mean, these things are the reality of life. Yeah, you need luck. Definitely you need luck. Without luck, you cannot get through the top 1% or work into the best companies. I also love this one who is talking about consistency. Don't plateau once you've learned enough to get paid. I've seen many, many brilliant engineers sticking to their comfort zone while the real elite always keep pushing. They seek tougher problems. They learn new languages and familiar architectures. And bonus tip, never be the smartest person in the room. I mean, if you're in a team and you are the smartest guy there, then you have a problem. You won't learn there. Try to surround yourself with people who are smarter than you and who can challenge you on a daily basis. So I also love this one. Some people claim that the top devs are lone wolf nerds, robots who live in code caves, or, you know, people like you cannot communicate with them. I see this as a joke. To be honest, I believe if there is a guy you cannot talk with, then that guy cannot crack to the top 1%. You know, nobody wants to pair program with a brick wall. Soft skills aren't optional, guys. Soft skills are very, very important. You need to learn to translate your genius into plain English. You need to build relationship. You need to sell your ideas. Otherwise, you will just be the smartest mute person in the room and you would never go through the top 1%. I also like this comment. It has some cool points. You need to embrace change. And he is also talking about Uncle Bob's clean code, like the book that says the method should be under 20 lines, which is a stupid in my opinion. The book that says you should never repeat yourself. I mean, but that one is also not very true. Sometimes repeating yourself is better than creating a lot of abstraction, inheritance, and different stuff, and make your code more and more complicated just because you don't want to repeat yourself. I mean, code is a living thing. It's like a monster that you need to tweak it, you need to smash it, you need to rewrite it every day. And you know, any rule that shows up and it slows down you through that process, you need to break it, because you need to be open to change your code. You should not look at your code like a piece of art that is in the... I mean, you should be always open to learn something new and change your code. And if you want opportunity to learn more, just dive into open source projects. There are a lot of real bugs and people there give you brutal feedback and you can have some real growth there. There are some projects, some crazy project like Apache Kafka. You can contribute in them and you can learn a lot. Really top 1% developers are working there and you can go among them. You know, there is no filter. You can go among them, you can choose the issue, work on that and fix it.